Hi, Tina Thorburn here from the Highways team with another regular update about work being done on Surrey's roads. We'll be working on several resurfacing schemes over the coming days. Overnight work is due to start on the 15th of October on Puttenham Heath Road in Compton. It's expected to take until the 27th of October, and while the road is closed between 8 p.m. and 6 a.m, a signposted diversion will operate. From the 15th of October, we'll be spending 2 nights resurfacing Bisley Camp Road in Pirbright. We'll be at Bunce Common Road in Lee for 2 days from the 8th of October, which means it will be closed between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. from Newdigate Road to Tapners Road. Meanwhile, our resurfacing scheme at the A23 Hawley Road is going well. The work, which we aim to finish by the 27th of October, is being done overnight with a signposted diversion route in place. Work has begun to improve pedestrian safety in Guildford. Raised road tables are being placed at the traffic signal crossing points across Onslow Street at the junction with Bridge Street. This should take around 4 weeks, but most of the work is being done at night with a few lane closures during the day. More information can be found at www.rroads.today. Our scheme in Epsom to reduce congestion and improve the town centre's appearance continues, and work at the Spread Eagle Junction is progressing well. We realise this is causing disruption, but thank drivers for their patience. The crossing between the Coral Betting Shop and the Metro Bank is closed at the moment, but there are several others at the junction, as well as those outside the Ashley Centre and Epsom Square. However, to help people, we are providing traffic marshals. Moving on to Bagshot, we'll be starting to build a shared use path for pedestrians and cyclists along the southern side of the A30 London Road between the Jolly Farmer Junction and Waterers Way on the 9th of October. Hopefully, most of the work, which is due to last around 12 weeks, will take place under temporary lane closures, but temporary traffic lights will be needed at certain times for safety reasons. And finally, we expect to be able to reopen Shelvers Way in Tadworth, which has been closed for emergency drainage work, by the end of next week. That's all for now. I'll be back soon with more updates about work taking place on Surrey's roads.